everyone, and welcome to a special edition of Mass United Insurance's Line and Length. I'm Barry Wilkinson. We're on location at Kensington Oval. People are still celebrating even a week later as the West Indies pulled off what I thought was a fantastic victory. Andrew Seeley is with me. The Wisden series drawn, and Andrew, that's going to be the focus of our attention on our program today. Who do we have?
Well, it's certainly a special one, Barry, and Jeffrey Dujon, he's excited too, not normally, and Ian Bishop reporting on what was an interesting victory by the West Indies from the point of view that it was won by the young members of the team.
Indeed. We're also going to hear from Phil Simmons, the coach, his first victory in that capacity. Denesh, Ramdin, Darren Bravo, and the man of the match, Jermaine Blackwood. This is Mass United Insurance's Line and Length. Stay tuned for a bumper edition.
Across the Caribbean, more people are placing their trust in Massey United Insurance for the protection of the things that are important to them, their homes, businesses, and their prized possessions. That's because Massey United Insurance offers excellent general insurance coverage to help you manage whatever life sends your way. Our cadre of well-reputed agencies and trained insurance professionals are always ready to provide you with sound advice and prompt service. Choose the security and sound strength that is Massey United Insurance.
Playing cricket for West Indies is hard work. That's why you need the best shoes.
Bowling fast is harder than it looks. And don't forget batting. I can do that too.
You need to have the best equipment to achieve optimum results.
Being in the center, all eyes are on me. Gotta look my best.
For over three decades, Sports and Games Barbados Limited has been outfitting professional, amateur, and young athletes with the best gear. Whatever your sporting needs, you are sure to meet them there. Corner of James and Roebuck Street.
Sports and Games, we are the home of champions.
Welcome back then to Mass United Insurance's Line and Length. Ian Bishop is with me. And Ian, as we reflect on this test match, what was the most pleasing aspect in your opinion?
A couple of things. Jermaine Blackwood's batting, showing the type of aggression that he normally does, but also being much more considered in the second innings of a test match. I think that's very pleasing from the West Indies perspective, that he has that versatility in his batting armory. Also the bowling. I thought it was the bowling that brought the West Indies back in the test match after giving up a lead. Jason Holder bowled well. Shannon Gabriel continues to be consistent. And then Jerome Taylor shows that he has a great range of skill and really is maturing. So those two points stand out for me.
Now, we've used this term loosely within the last couple of years every time the West Indies have a spot good performance, which is, have they turned the corner? How do you assess West Indies cricket in test right now at this stage after beating England here for the first time in about 16 years, apparently?
This was a tremendous victory. When you consider several things, the losses in South Africa late last year, and also the collapse again up in Grenada, to recover from that and to come from behind and get a victory here is very, very important. It shows there's so many good things that the West Indies have, nice young batsmen, bowlers coming to the fore. As far as turning the corner, it's something the fans use, but really, how do you decide when that is? Australia coming next, the performances there will determine and give a better idea of where this team is. But I think you will have to look over the next year and a half, Barry, or maybe 2 years. And if the West Indies can continue putting up good performances, turning over a few opponents, then we will be able to finally say the future. We've turned the corner.
The performance of Denesh Ramdin, how do you assess his performance as a captain of the West Indies team?
I think over the course of a series, he got better. He plays an attritional form of cricket where he's very careful about attacking and over-attacking. I'd like to see that maybe change a little bit and he can attack a little bit more, but then he has to work with the tools that he has. Now that he's getting more confidence in his bowlers, I expect to see him elevate the way he attacks more. And the attrition is good for now. It served his job today, but I'd like to see him evolve where that is concerned later on.
Final question. I asked you before the series started if you thought that Phil Simmons would have a better relationship with the players than perhaps Otis Gibson ended with them. Do you think that this victory perhaps has shown that he is beginning to get through to a young brigade who has shown that they didn't listen before in the future, in the past?
It looks that way, and we will know long term, because what with coaching, what you always have to remember is that you can have one good series, but it's how you go from series to series. Little potholes can develop, little hurdles and obstacles can develop. So Phil is now very experienced. When I played with him, and when he was coaching and I was managing Trinidad and Tobago at the back end of our careers, when we finished, he was a little bit lacking, maybe in, like I was, a little bit short on patience. But he has learned that over time, there's no need to shout at guys at all unless it comes down to a very difficult situation. He's very level-headed, very knowledgeable, and I think part of this result here has to go to him, because he got young batsmen who made mistakes to pick up their game thereafter, bowlers to understand, along with Curtly Ambrose, Stuart Williams, Andre Cooley, what the importance is, and never to give up, Barry. They haven't given up. So I think Phil deserves credit, because when the team loses, he'll get some stick as well. So you have to give him credit when they win.
All right, great stuff there then from Ian Bishop. Let's hear what Phil Simmons has to say when we come back right here on Mass United Insurance's Line and Length.
Across the Caribbean, more people are placing their trust in Massey United Insurance for the protection of the things that are important to them, their homes, businesses, and their prized possessions. That's because Massey United Insurance offers excellent general insurance coverage to help you manage whatever life sends your way. Our cadre of well-reputed agencies and trained insurance professionals are always ready to provide you with sound advice and prompt service. Choose the security and sound strength that is Massey United Insurance.
Well, welcome back to the program. With me is the winning coach of the West Indies, Phil Simmons. Phil, congratulations. First victory as coach.
Thank you. It's a welcome one. It's great to draw the series and make sure we come out of the series with something, because the guys really worked hard during the series.
What do you think in this game, as you reflect, what really went right for the West Indies? Was it the batting aspect or that second innings bowling performance?
I think when we bowled well right through, and on the wicket how it was, the bowling came up trumps. And I think when you look at things, the way how backward batted both innings helped us through, but the bowlers were exceptional for the whole game.
If you had to single out one bowler, who would that be, and perhaps one batsman?
I don't think you could single out one. I think the three seamers especially. I think Pumal and came into his own in the second inning. Marlon bowled really well for us in the first inning. But the three seamers on a wicket like that, they worked really hard, and I am appreciative of how hard they worked.
Now, when you first took this job, you took it at a time where West Indies cricket was still shaky. Now you've been in it for at least a month or so. What are the areas you think that you're beginning to work the chinks out?
All areas are beginning to work. I think the whole thing is that guys are a little more relaxed and playing with that heart and soul that we want them to play with when they're playing for West Indies. So it's good to see that, and it's good to see them working hard, because guys are doing the work and working very hard in practice and in fielding and everything. So everything's coming together, and we hope we just get better and better.
Now, the West Indies now play against Australia. How much will this victory do for their psyche? And what is the preparation going to be like going forward now to that Australian series?
It's massive for the psyche, because you're going into from number three team to number one team. And it's massive for the psyche to know that we can compete up at that level. And it will help us in our preparation. We'll be here for about a week later on in the month, preparing for Australia in Dominica.
We want to single out perhaps Curtly Ambrose as well. The bowling coach has been working tirelessly since New Zealand and South Africa. How does he come here and help in terms of knowing this pitch very well?
Yeah, I don't think knowing the pitch. I think the pitch was different to when we played. But just the fact that the insight into how Test cricket works and things like that, he's very good at that with the guys. So he's been brilliant with them from that point of view, you know. So it's great to have him on board.
Wonderful stuff. So it's Phil Simmons, winning coach of the West Indies team, drawing this series. So Darren Bravo having a great return to form. First of all, Darren, how do you feel about the victory for the West Indies?
Yeah, it's a great feeling indeed. Obviously, we played a tremendous test series against the English. We knew they were going to be a very tough opposition. And I know I just want to say congratulations to the entire West Indies team.
In the last match, you were beginning to show signs that you were getting back there. You made 69, but then you got out. How have you been going in the nets working on your game? Because everyone knows that Darren Bravo is accustomed to playing long innings.
Yeah, I think I did. I worked on my game in the nets here in Barbados. Obviously, I didn't bat well in the first innings. I knew, you know, I had to put my hand up in this match, and you know, I just want to thank everyone who sent me, you know, important messages, you know, to back myself, you know, stay confident, and you know, I just went out there and back myself today. I must say, well played to Blackwood as well. He had a tremendous series as well, so it's great to know that we are playing competitive Test cricket once more, and hopefully we can move on from strength to strength.
Now, I know when you just started your career, you were very close to fit in with your second cousin, Brian Lara. Has he been in contact with you recently to give you some advice?
Yeah, actually, yesterday was his birthday, and I messaged him yesterday morning and tell him that, you know, happy birthday, Brian, love always, and I'll try my best to give you a birthday gift today. He replied and said that will be nice. He's waiting on it, so I wasn't able to do that in the first innings, but in the second innings, I tried my best, so I just want to dedicate this innings to him.
Have you got back at your colleague, Denesh Ramdin? He poked fun at you on Twitter saying that you look like Colin Croft's son.
Yeah, Ramdin and I go way back. I think we have a very good friendship. I can remember, you know, while we were feeling in the second innings, I tell him, don't worry, as long as we bowl on England cheaply, I'm going to try my best to win the game for him. And, you know, I just went out there and backed myself. Congratulations to him. Obviously, it's a drawn series against England. They're a high-ranked team, and it's a good feeling. The camp is in a very high spirits right now, and obviously, we're looking forward to the Australia series now, I guess.
And how are you recovering from, you know, the personal break you took from cricket? How are you recovering from that?
Now, all is well. Everything is good and proper right now. I'm happy. And I just want to continue, you know, working hard on my game and continue performing for West Indies.
And you heard from your brother recently?
Actually, he just messaged me. You know, he told me congratulations. He stayed up all night to look at me bat. So, you know, I'm really happy about that. Obviously, I look up to him. He's been always there for me, you know, through the good times and the bad times. And that is something that I will never take for granted. So I just want to, you know, say thanks to him a lot.
All right. So Darren Bravo, a real champion innings, one that led the West Indies to victory. Jermaine Blackwood, obvious man of the match. Jermaine, first of all, in the last match, I was critical of you. I said you didn't show that restraint. Total contrast this game. Tell me about how you feel about the performance.
Well, I feel very good in myself. I went there and see Bravo. The pitch is a bit up and down, so I just knew once me and Bravo, but majority of the over are but a session, maybe a session and a half, we know we're going to get close to our target. So me and Bravo were just there, take it 10 runs, and we certainly did that. So I just want to say well played to Bravo as well.
You said to me that Test cricket, T20 cricket, 50 over cricket, Test is your favourite. Does this mean that you're going to be around for a long time in Test cricket?
Well, I plan to stay around for a long time. I really enjoy playing Test cricket because it's a lot of pressure, and I love playing down under pressure. So I'm a big lover of Test cricket.
You look at the pitch; it was a difficult one to bat on, but you made it look quite easy. You said you had to dig in. What was the thought process today?
Well, it was keeping a bit low. It was spinning when the pace bowler was bowling. Some of the bar was pretty slow. Some come through. Some was keeping low. So remember, I was out there. We just have to work hard and just keep on fighting, because you know, once we put on a big partnership, we're certainly gonna win the game.
And you want to pay homage to your coach Simmons?
Yeah. I just want to say thanks to Simmons. He worked with me a lot in the nets, and I also want to say thanks to Coley and Stuart. They worked with me very, very hard in the nets when I'm trying to find out my weak areas and trying to bat as long as possible in the nets.
Can't forget Russell and Chris.
Well, certainly they are my two role models, man. I really look up to them. So I want to say shout out to them both.
So I'm with Denesh Ramdin, the winning West Indies captain. Denesh, congratulations. You must feel very proud about this.
Yeah, very happy. The guys went out of the fourth out. You know, the bowlers put us in a position to take away the game. Our batters didn't do that on the first innings, but our bowlers came back well on the second day, and our batters finished it off today.
In the last match, we had a situation where Jermaine Blackwood, his restraint wasn't that great. Today, it was a total contrast. And even in the first innings, how proud are you of Jermaine Blackwood?
Yeah, I'm very happy. And the more he played, the more he's growing in confidence and he's learning, and that experience is carrying him through. He batted fantastically well today, carried the team right down and won the game for us. Darren Bravo, he went out there and he told me he's going to do it for me and the team. And he went out there. It was unlucky he got out there, but you know, he did it.
You look at the fact that Bravo, like you said, did not have a good series by his standards. Is he beginning to come back into this mold?
Yeah, we had a long chat, you know, just some shots that he made, you know, that cost him his wicket. He got starts, but he didn't carry on. But hopefully this is good things to come going to the next series against Australia.
I was just going to ask you about that. How do you think this victory will do for the Australian series to come?
Yeah, that's a confidence booster. It showed us that we could go there and bowl in right areas, bat for long periods, and compete with the teams that rank above us and win games as well.
And Coach Simmons was elated himself.
Yeah, first game, first series drawn, and a win, a test win, fantastic. He came to the Caribbean with this work ethic that we needed to push ourselves hard in training. We did that, and now we saw the results.
All right, wonderful. Anybody want to congratulate in terms of the perhaps the fans as well?
Yeah, the fans was fantastic, and they came out in Antigua, they came out in Grenada, and here they came out again. You know, they came out and backed us, and now we could have joined the series. The entire coaching staff and all the family and friends who wish us well.
All right, so Denesh Ramdin, very happy. West Indies captain, as he should be.
Across the Caribbean, more people are placing their trust in Massey United Insurance for the protection of the things that are important to them, their homes, businesses, and their prized possessions. That's because Massey United Insurance offers excellent general insurance coverage to help you manage whatever life sends your way. Our cadre of well-reputed agencies and trained insurance professionals are always ready to provide you with sound advice and prompt service. Choose the security and sound strength that is Massey United Insurance.
And welcome back to Massey United Insurance's Line of Life. And with me, Jeffrey Dujon, former West Indies wicketkeeper batsman, now international cricket commentator. Jeff, an amazing test match at Kensington Oval.
An amazing test match, Andrew, on a number of levels.
Well, let's look at it. Expectation to finish a test match in 3 days, Jeffrey.
Well, that is something that used to happen quite regularly when I played, but for a totally different reason. I think we saw a test match here that was poor in the sense that the batting was extremely poor. On the other hand, I thought the bowling was extremely good, and it kept the interest alive. It could have gone up until this morning. It could have gone either way. But some poor cricket, an exciting test match nevertheless.
Talk a bit about the pitch, because often when a game finishes in 3 days, we attribute blame to the pitch. Your thoughts on the pitch here at Kensington?
Well, I don't think really, when I looked at it, I thought about it, that the pitch really caused anybody to get out. It did deteriorate a bit quickly, unlike a normal Kensington pitch. But it turned out to be a flat pitch, which a good spinner could utilize.
How do we relate the fact that England rated number 3 versus West Indies number 8? The series ends 1-1, and in fact, West Indies end on the bigger high.
Well, it's a big shock for England, I can tell you that. After they won in Grenada, I think that the talk I heard was that, well, they just come and sweep this test match here as well. They would do all the support that they would get here et al. But, you know, they came, they played some poor cricket. They batted badly. And even though they got a lead in the first innings, they didn't capitalize on it. And the West Indies ended up in a position where if they just did done what we've been asking them to do for the longest time, they would have won the test match, and they ended up winning it handily.
Any lessons to be learned, of course, especially for the West Indies? We have introduced a number of new young players, and some of them have certainly done better than the more established and experienced ones.
Well, I'm still a little bit worried about the batting. Mm-hmm. The bowling, I think, is coming along in terms of, you know, the fact that I think Kirtley Ambrose has done a good job in terms of getting the bowlers a little bit more disciplined, a little bit more consistent. And but I'm really think that we're still struggling around for some batting. And it's starting to appear to me that possibly Shivnarine Chandrapal is what you experiencing what you would call the law of diminishing returns, you know. So that's another concern, because he's been a stalwart for us. We're still looking for another opener, and I still think, you know, taking nothing away from the way he batted today, but I still think that we're looking for a number 3 as well. I would look to Darren Bravo to be a little bit deeper in the order.
Okay, as we go forward now, Jeff, because obviously this is finished now. Australia come here in June. Your thoughts are much stiffer opposition, certainly, and I don't think Australia will buckle as England did.
No, those are the big boys. That's a totally different kettle of fish, a horse of a different color, whatever you want to call it. And we're going to be severely tested. You know, we will be put to the sword with the bat, and we will be seriously examined by their bowling, which we know is a very powerful unit. It's going to be a good experience, I think, for us. And I'm hoping that it will be a good experience for some young, new players.
In terms of advertisement for Test cricket, the excitement began from ball one and ended on the last ball on day three. A good advertisement for Test cricket. So much talk about Test cricket being boring. Was this a good advertisement?
Well, it was an exciting Test match, let's put it that way. But it was made exciting by some poor cricket. So I'm not sure if it's that good an advertisement for Test cricket, but it just shows that you can have some excitement if you're willing to bat badly twice.
That's Geoffrey Dujon, former West Indies wicketkeeper batsman, and himself an outstanding Test player. And you're watching Massey United Insurance's Line and Length.
Across the Caribbean, more people are placing their trust in Massey United Insurance for the protection of the things that are important to them, their homes, businesses, and their prized possessions. That's because Massey United Insurance offers excellent general insurance coverage to help you manage whatever life sends your way. Our cadre of well-reputed agencies and trained insurance professionals are always ready to provide you with sound advice and prompt service. Choose the security and sound strength that is Massey United Insurance.
Back on Massey United Insurance's Line and Line for Scotsman in the Caribbean. Your thoughts on today's victory by the West Indies?
Thoroughly deserved. The better side won, absolutely. You've got some smashing young players. I know that half of your guys are in India, but the half I've left behind are pretty good.
You enjoyed your time in Barbados?
Enjoyed my time in Barbados. I've still got another week to go. I would rather be watching cricket tomorrow and the next day, but hey-ho. That's cricket for you.
Tell us about the loss here.
Well, it was the disappointing thing was yesterday evening when England lost 5 wickets a bit too quickly. And that put us under a lot of pressure today. And the West Indies deserved to win the match.
Okay, and you're a lovely lady here. You enjoyed the game?
Yeah, I'm not very used to cricket, but I've really enjoyed 3 days here, yes.
Well, it's good to be back in the studio now after all of the chaos, good chaos, mind you, that happened there at Kensington Oval. And with us are some very special people because we have a good announcement to make just ahead of the local association, Barbados Cricket Association season. We have a very good sponsorship for a club that has been doing well. It's now going to be known as Massey United Insurance Wildy, the club just there by the Caribbean Broadcasting Corporation on the grounds of the Samuel Jackman Prescott Polytechnic. With me to talk a little bit about that big sponsor is Sharon Aline Alcock, who of course is from Mass United Insurance. The president of the club, Mark Estwick, you would have recognized Mark, of course, he's played so many years for the YMPC club. And Andrew Seeley, it's good to have Andrew back in the thick of things. Ladies always go first on this program whenever we have them. Sharon, it's so good to see you. Many people wouldn't know, but you are one of the pioneers behind this program. So it's good to have you in the studio.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
I'm sure that you're happy about this sponsorship because you've been getting into cricket in a big way.
Yes, we are very excited about this sponsorship. This is a fantastic team that we are now fully behind. The Wildy Sports Club is an exciting group team. They're doing exciting things out there, and we want to be a part of that. We want to give them the support they require to be even bigger and better.
Now, you know, Mass United Insurance, when they do things, they do it in grand style. What can we look for when we pass during the local season? What can we look for branding-wise on that lovely club? Because it's very visible.
Yes. Well, already we've branded. The branding is there on the gate. So as you enter the compound, as you enter the grounds, we have our branding on the gate. So as everybody knows that we're involved and that this is the Wildy Club. And then we're also going to be, there's signage as well in terms of the scoreboard. We have signage in place already. We have their uniforms, exciting, exciting branding. We're really excited about the uniforms. They're looking good out on the field. And so far, that's where we've headed.
Right. Now, I'll get back to about to where Mass United Insurance is sponsoring other things. But Mark, this is going to be an important year because it's no international cricket to start the season. And all of the cricketers like it when it's like that because you have big players coming in. Who are some of the big players will be playing for Mass United Insurance Wildy this year?
Well, this year we're very pleased to have back Carlos Braffett, who would have turned up for UWA over the last 5 years or so. We also have Aaron Jones, Joffa Archer, who is currently in England, but he'll be back later on in the season. I know these guys will complement the stars that we had from last year, who led us to the First Division Cup. Pedro Gribbs, who was the leader. I know Kofi Hurdle and lots of other guys who are there and chomping a bit to get going this year.
Season starts on May 16th. Tell me about the conditions, because that ground is in a basin, but it's been known for being a bit of a batting paradise. Tell me about some of the conditions you're going to have planned.
Well, the pitch is in very good shape. As you said, it's a batting paradise right now. The outfield is in fine shape as well. You know, it's starting with 2020, which obviously you need good conditions to play so the scores and so on can be good and the batsmen can revel in those conditions.
And I'm sure you're happy for the sponsorship, because without sponsorship, things can't progress.
Undoubtedly, we are extremely happy that Massey United Insurance has come on board to help us. It takes a lot of money to run a club on a yearly basis, you know, something between $50,000 to $70,000. Wow. So this sponsor is extremely valuable, and we're going to make Massey United Insurance proud.
Right, they're going to hold you to that. So now, Sharon, Mass United Insurance have been since the big rebrand almost a year now. They've been doing a lot of projects.
Yes, definitely. And most of our projects are focused, if not all of them, on our customer. We're all about making sure our customer is first and focusing on them. So we've already embarked internally on a new customer service management system. It's all about improving our customer service. Clients are accustomed to getting great service from Mass United Insurance, but we know that in order to excel and to remain competitive in the market, we have to take it up a notch. And as with everything else that we do for our customer, we are indeed going a lot farther, and we are going to be extending ourselves and making sure that service that you experience, that the client experiences, is significantly improved and enhanced. And it's all about creating awareness internally too of that client who every single day comes to us. We have a loyal customer base, and it's important that we give them the attention, the respect, and the love and care that they deserve.
All right, going forward, we want to do more sporting activities as well?
Yes, we continue to be a major developer of sports in the Caribbean, in Barbados and the Caribbean, and we want to continue developing sport in Barbados. We know that via sport, it's an excellent conduit for performance and for developing the youth, especially in Barbados, and we want to be part of that further development. It's not just about now, it's about the future and our participation in developing what's coming in the future.
All right, wonderful stuff. So I can't wait for the start of the season for many reasons. I want to see what the new Mass United Insurance Wildy they'll do. Formerly, we all know that years gone by, they used to be known as the Banks Sports Club. But since it's transformed, they've certainly been doing much better, perhaps as a sponsorship. Who knows? We look forward to a great season. And don't forget, you can follow the Division 1 season. We'll tell you all the results right here on Mass United Insurance's Line and Length. So that's it then from Kensington Oval and a special edition of Mass United Insurance's Line and Length. Well done to the West Indies. We take a little break in terms of how they are playing on the field cricket now. The next series starts June the 3rd, and that will be in Dominica against Australia.
And that's a big one, as mentioned by Geoffrey Dujon. Australia, a whole different kettle of fish.
Next week, we'll turn our attention a little bit and start focusing on the business end of the Pepsi IPL. We have, I wouldn't say ignored that tournament over the last couple of weeks, but we are certainly going to focus on that now that the West Indies are not playing. Thank you so much for joining us on Mass United Insurance's Line and Length. We'll see you next week. Goodbye for now.